a day of boating for you and I and our families out on the water, it's going to cost us about $11.
Inconceivable!
It's the Green Boater, and we are at the Seattle Boat Show. And this year, there are so many exciting products here that we haven't seen before. And one of them is just stunning. And it is this boat that we're sitting on right now. And I'm so pleased that we're able to capture some time with Josh at Xshore to talk about this amazing boat. Josh, thank you so much for having us aboard. Tell us, first of all, about the company and then this venture into this boat.
There's a lot of pieces that come into it. Number one was we wanted to design a boat that was thinking about the environment. How do we reduce carbon emissions? But we wanted to take it a little bit further because when you build a boat, there's obviously a lot of waste, a lot of excess, the materials you use. So the boat is not just an electric vessel. It's more of an overarching idea. So little things you'll see around the boat, like a cork deck. Cork is a natural product. It comes out, it's sustainable. Tree isn't harmed in the process. It's also lighter weight. It's easy to take care of. Little pieces like that are really where we wanted to focus. We had the idea in 2016. I would say some of the pieces of the puzzle were there, but they weren't all assembled. By 2019, we had taken most of those pieces, we had built prototype boats, and by 2021, we moved into production. Just last year, we moved into a new, bigger facility, so we're scaling up as well. And at the end of the day, you can see this boat, which is the Eelex.
The whole boating industry is just booming with electric propulsion. Is this boat a different concept?
I like to think about it the way my father did, you know, back in the day. He goes, if you're going to buy something from someone, that's all they do. You know, those companies that make everything usually don't do anything very well. So we make the boat, and obviously we integrate our systems and our software, and those are very proprietary to us. The motor comes from a company called Brusa, fantastic builder, DC brushless motor. Then the batteries come from a company called Chrysal, not to be confused with Chrysler, but Chrysal. In that battery system, we've got a glycol cooling system, and that's really integral to this boat and getting the performance that we do get out of this boat on the water.
So let's talk about performance, because everybody wants to know how fast, you know, how long does it take to regenerate, those kinds of questions.
Top speed, 30 knots. I think the more important fact there is acceleration. So with electric motors, we've got torque.
Instant.
Exactly. Usually I make sure when everybody drives the boat for the first time, before you hit the throttle, everybody's got to be sitting. So we're about 4.3 seconds from 0 to 20 knots in a 5,700 pound boat. You've got the performance, have fun. I mean, just above our heads, you can see that hook. That's for water skiing. There's no trouble there.
Have you been on this boat when it's been in the water?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, tell me what that was like.
I'll be honest. I was out with one of our other staff who's an incredibly capable boat driver and had been on the company a little bit longer than I had. We were coming out of the slip, ghosting along, doing about 5 knots, and there is no noise. Legitimately, no noise. And I found myself with the throttle, just every couple seconds, I would just give it a little goose.
Well, so you were driving.
I was driving.
Okay.
And I get this tap, like, you okay? I think I'm okay. You don't think it works, do you? I'm like, I'm not sure. I just want to make sure I've still got power. He goes, you'll get used to it. Trust me. You'll be fine. It took me, I would say, the better part of like an hour and a half, 2 hours to really settle in and go, okay, it's okay that it doesn't make any noise. It doesn't vibrate. It doesn't have all of those things that I've used to correlate operation to me. So now I'm relying on this giant digital display with a spinning propeller and RPM and going, oh, I trust you.
And no noise.
No noise at all. I mean, we even have—
You hear water rushing by.
The water coming across the hull is the loudest thing. I mean, there's a mode which limits you about 5 knots called Power of Silence. And the idea is we wanted to basically make the best interaction between you, the vessel, and the environment you're in. And that was really critical. And when you're out on the water with no noise, you can have your favorite music playing on the stereo. You can have a conversation without screaming. It really changes everything about boating.
Well, I think also people have to take into like the price point. The maintenance cost.
Nothing. There is no oils to change, no fuel to buy.
Damn you.
I know.
Damn you.
We change zincs and we look at small sight glasses to make sure they have fluid. That's it.
I have a vintage 73 50 foot boat and I spend probably half my time in the engine room cleaning things up. I'm mopping things. I mean, you love it down there, but
do you though?
Do
you
really
love it? Do you? We can be honest. We're being friends here. You can be honest.
Well, if I have bad company upstairs, that's a good place to go hide.
All right.
But no, I'd rather be boating.
Absolutely. And this changes a lot of that. I mean, and it's being able to enjoy your friends, your family, and not have to go the maintenance nightmares and all the things that go with it. It's just a day of boating for you and I and our families out on the water. It's going to cost us about $11. That's really hard to attain And
I'm starting to really hate you. I'm going to have to buy one of these.
You don't have to hate me. You can just buy a boat and you'll be right on the same board with us.
I hope you're enjoying this episode of the Green Boater TV. I would very much appreciate if you could hit the subscribe button, the like button. It helps us keep the channel going. Now, back to the episode.
Just change one thing.
As you go out, range is obviously subjective. So the harder you drive the boat, the more you're going to push the battery down. You can do, say, 5 to 7 knots cruising in absolute silence, and you're going to do that for about 100 nautical miles. You pick that speed up, we're going to plane out around 17 knots. You can do upwards of 40 to 50 miles there. One thing that is worth pointing out, and you can probably see it in the frame behind us, but our software, the way it works with the motor, with the battery, with the vessel, and obviously you as the operator, we're taking 150 data points a second on this boat, and we're calculating in real time your battery percentage, but also your real-time range. And so as you accelerate or decelerate, we're telling you this is the range you have at that exact moment with the payload, the sea state, and that's forever being analyzed and updated.
What about recharging?
So it was great. The marine infrastructure already existed. Shore power. That's all you needed. 30 and 50 amp shore power. 50 amp 220 is fantastic. Obviously, it's going to be a little bit quicker to charge our system, but there's also a network of DC fast charging coming out. So you're looking at charge speeds that could be an hour on this boat. To a full charge.
The boat is production ready?
We are in production.
In production, we're selling?
We are selling. So this boat we're sitting on is hull 55. We have hulls through almost 80 on the Eelex completed. And the more exciting part of that is we've got our new boat called the Xshore 1, which got released this year. It's a 21-foot boat, comes in two forms, an open and a top. That boat will be in production in April, probably delivered in the US in Q3, but more price focused.
Okay.
And we wanted to get more people into the electric boating market. And so by finding something that starts at $139,000 for a turnkey boat, everything's there. That's a lot more obtainable for the average boater. We're building a production boat that's built more like a Grand Prix race boat. And so that strength, the fit, the finish, all those parts start to come together and you end up with this.
Did I understand that the boat actually can be componentized to different types of boating you?
Absolutely. So the seat that we're sitting on right now, 4 or 5 millimeter Allen bolts. And you and I lifting it out, which takes about 2 minutes, we could rearrange the deck. We could keep this table in. We could take these two tables, turn them, spin them, or we just remove it all. And you'd have basically a pickup truck for the sea. You could also get a module for diving or fishing. Sky's the limit. And at any day, you can adjust for what you want to do with one hull.
One of the things that impressed me about reading a little bit about your company is that you've actually tapped into maybe a new way of thinking, which can you speak to that a little bit? Because that must make you pretty proud.
When I go to bed at night, I feel good about what I do. To find a company that actually aligns with all those things that sort of near and dear to your heart, you know, and it's everything. Our business cards are biodegradable. Products that we purchase for our employees obviously are environmentally conscious. The clothing that we do, it's everything in the system and trying to just do things a little better. I think if we chip away at it, it's gonna get there. You know, and we obviously have our goals to be, you know, carbon neutral by 2030, which is, it's tough, but we're doing a great job. We're getting there. So I feel like we're in the right direction.
Where can they find out more information about your company as well as this boat and the ones that you mentioned are coming?
Xshore.com, really easy to find. And then as you get into the webpage, there's going to be obviously specifics on the boat itself and our new model, the Xshore 1. You're going to be able to go through a lot of our policies, our sustainability, and a lot of questions. I mean, in electric boating, it's new. People have questions. So always reach out to us. The contacts are there.
Thank you so much for having us aboard and introducing us to Xshore and this company.
Morris, thank you.
Thank you for watching this episode of the Green Boater TV. We are looking for 1 million boaters that are willing to change one thing and how they do their boating to help stop ocean pollution. Perhaps this video contained it. Subscribe to this channel for other ideas about how you can create the ocean you love.